Wow, what a beautiful creature, guys. This is Eupacardia caleta, the caleta silk moth. It is found in Mexico, Guatemala, Honduras, but also the United States of America, mainly in Texas, New Mexico, and Arizona. This species is present in very hot and dry deserts and flies in thorn scrub, foothills, and canyons of the desert mountain ranges. In the wild, caterpillars feed on Senisa, Leucophyllum fructescens, ash tree or Fraxinus, Mexican jumping bean or Sapium biloculare, and Octio or Fruqueria splendens. In captivity, they can also be raised by hobbyists on willow tree or salix, Prunus or cherries, Ligustrum or privet, Syringa vulgaris or lilac, and Rus or sumac. This species produces one or two broods per year. Cocoons can go into diapause in winter. In captivity, this species can be a little bit frustrating to raise because the caterpillars can be very sensitive to diseases and overcrowding. They prefer a hot and dry enclosure with fresh food plants. One thing that is notable is the ability of this species to diapause. Upon spinning cocoons, it can sometimes take several years for the moths to hatch from said cocoons. In fact, the moth you are looking at right now in this video just eclosed from a 3-year-old cocoon that I obtained in 2017. The key to making the moths hatch is to keep the cocoons hot and humid. They always seem to hatch during heat waves in captivity. Pairings usually happen very early in the morning. The moths live for about 2 weeks, only to eventually run out of energy and die, and after having paired and laid eggs. Thank you for watching my short but educational video showing you a female specimen of Eupacardia caleta. This is Bart out.